I really am drawn to things that have been used and things that have a story attached to them.
Oh, wow.
Lauren and I are constantly foraging and collecting things, found objects, or going to flea markets, and I really like to have things that are weathered and worn.
It speaks to me personally a little bit more than something that's brand new out of the box. My name is Jed Winokur, and I work in the Coach Archive, and I call myself an archivist.
When you look for me, I'll be at the bottom of the deep blue sea.
I think that it's really important to be able to organize and edit and collect. So to me, you can have a pile of things that you've collected, but it's even better to take those things and edit it down to the essence and then organize them in a way that they can be aesthetically pleasing. My job is to preserve and protect over 20,000 handbags and small leather goods dating all the way back to when the company was founded in 1941. So I'm surrounded by 23 glass cases that are filled with Coach product. It's something that's constantly growing. As we release new product, we bring it into the archive and we catalog all of these pieces and put it into an order that makes sense.
Our primary purpose is to function as a design archive.
Hey, Jed.
Hey,
how are you?
Nice
to see you.
Thanks for coming down.
To be able to work with people who are creating new things.
So whenever a designer is designing a new bag, they'll really reference some of the pieces in the archive.
I think these linings are absolutely perfect. These could go into bags today and look completely modern.
I think that I'm drawn to archives in general because there's something really interesting in the life of a company and how does that get organized. What does it mean in 100 years when we look back at this time frame and how is that presented and what does that mean? Being surrounded by collections as much as I am, I look at the idea of editing is really the challenge for me. Editing is really our attempt to put things into an order. And I think that there's something very human about that, and I think that was my draw to working as an archivist.